It's finally here, TanStack AI, the project I've been working on for the last month in kind of a secret, kind of not, and today I'm gonna talk about it. You might have already seen the blog post that's over here. The blog post itself goes over what we've built and why it's so cool, but today I'm not really gonna go through this blog post because you can read it on your own time. What we are gonna do is I'm gonna show it to you. So we have prepared an example, and let's explore it together. So check this out. This is a TanStack start app, and this would work in any kind of app, so React, Router, Next.js, whatever. And this is a built custom chat with an actual LLM. And what we are gonna do is we're gonna explore what we can do with it. Before I input anything, the system prompt here is set for it to be a guitar selling assistant. So what it's going to do is it's going to recommend guitars, explain what guitars are, add them to cart and stuff like that. So without further ado, let's send our first message. And our first message is going to be, what's a guitar? And let's say in 10 words or less. All right. And it says a stringed musical instrument played by strumming or plucking. All right, awesome. Well, check out the DevTools. So basically, when you send any request, you're going to see it in real time in your DevTools. And this is the part of TanStack DevTools. So as you can see, it's just a plugin and you can actually enable other ones as well. So you can do something like this and then keep track of both at the same time. But today we're going to focus on TanStack AI. So whenever you send a message, it's going to tell you, hey, the user sent this message. And then the assistant splits into two parts. The first part is the client messages. So this is going to be updated in real time whenever you get responses back from the backend. So for example, the assistant responded with a string musical instrument played by strumming or plucking. And as you can see, that is the first message that's rendered because that's what gets triggered first. But you also get this second part here, that's the server message. And this is related to whatever happens on your backend. So for example, a string, the musical instrument played by strumming or plucking, took 15 chunks of data from the LLM provider to be streamed to our client to see the message. And if I open it up, you can see that the first message with content had 14 chunks, and these were all the chunks. And then it fired the done chunk and the chat was completed. So why this is also cool is because it also tells you how many tokens the input took and how many tokens the output took. And also you can see your registered tools. You can also see your LLM provider options and everything like temperature, top K and stuff like that. You can see the amount of input and output and total tokens that this conversation has taken up to this point. And you can also see what the model was, what the provider was, and how long the duration was. And this is all based per chat. So if you have multiple chats, you're going to see like multiple options here that you can click on and do whatever you want with. And that is the DevTools part. But as you can see, we have some tools registered. And if I lower this, what we can do is we can say, can you recommend a guitar to me? And what this is going to do is it's going to invoke a server tool. And if I open up the DevTools and scroll down, I find this message. And as you can see, what it did was it first fired the get guitars tool. And now we can expand this. We can see what the tool call was, what the arguments were that it finished. And then there was another call to get guitars. This was the tool result. I can just scroll through it, see what the tool returned. I can collapse it. And then when I'm done with this message, I can open up the second one. I can see that it called the recommend guitar tool. It returned the ID and it was done. And then on the client, you can also see the same information as you can see here, just a little bit more condensed. And that's the tool calls. And what we actually did was we sent a request to our LLM. It invoked some tools. The SDK automatically called the tools behind the scenes. sent it back to the LLM, and then the LLM responded with whatever it responded with, and we showed it in the UI. So if I actually close this and scroll up, you can see that it recommended this guitar to us. And I really like this guitar, but I'd like to add it to my cart. But how do I do that? Well, there's another tool for adding it to cart, and we can just say add to cart and enter, and it asks me to confirm. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be a little bit more specific, add the recommended guitar to my cart. And this is another built-in thing we have, and that is approvals. So how this works is if you mark a tool as needs approval, this is going to trigger a UI message that tells you, hey, can you approve this? Because, for example, if you want to delete something from the database, save it, or do some destructive actions or something like that, you want your user to actually confirm that. And we actually can also see this in the DevTools. If I bring it up, you can see that the add to cart needs approval. And then we can actually see that the approval was requested. And then we can either say approve or deny. I'm going to deny it because I didn't really implement the add to cart logic here. And that's pretty much it. So this is the actual demo. And this is all the features that the current alpha has. But let's go through the code together and let's actually talk about what's going on. All right, so this is an actual example from the TanStack AI repository. So don't worry about the workspace here. This is normal. It's just pulling from the workspace. And basically what we use is TanStack AI. And then you have your adapters like Anthropic, Gemini, Olamma, OpenAI. At the moment, we support these four, but there are other ones coming down the pipeline. So there's that. Then you have the AI client, that's the core chat experience, then the React adapter for it. We are also working on a component library for AI components like chat messages and stuff like that. So that's also coming down the pipeline. But for now, let's focus on the chat experience. So the first thing that we want to look at is the actual API route that actually runs all of this. And if we go back to our browser here, we can actually see that you can select a model. So that's important because what we do in the code is in the API route here, we import a bunch of tools, and then we have our adapters here, and then we have the chat from TanStack AI that powers the conversation. And basically what we do is we define the system prompt. So as I said, it must follow these instructions. This is what's important for it, blah, blah, blah. So this tells the LLM how it should act. And then we have the actual definitions of what the tools should do on the server. So how we do tools is really important. And why it's important is because we actually first tell you to define the tool. So you basically say the name, the description, the input, and the output schema, if it needs approval and stuff like that. And when you do that, in the place we're going to call the tool, we actually allow you to define the definition of what it's going to do. So for example, here on the server, when you do add to cart, it's just going to do this and return some dummy information. But here you would want to call a database, update the cart, blah, blah, blah. And because these input arguments here are actually typed, you could implement something like a const add to cart, and this actually gets the same args. And then basically you implement an implementation like db.insert, blah, blah, blah. And then you just basically plug it into here as an argument, and then you can actually use it in other places in your code not LLM related. So for example, if you have an add to cart button somewhere manually and you want to add it through an LLM as well, you can reuse code. So that's really cool. And then we have our handler route, and it takes a post request. And then basically what we do is we check if the request was aborted. If it was, just return a response. Otherwise, we create a abort controller, we get the body from the request, and we get the messages and the data from the body. And then this part here defines the provider and the model. So the example that we showed actually shows you how to use it with Anthropic, Olamma, OpenAI, and stuff like that, which is kind of really cool. And here we just check which adapter you're using and feed it to the chat. And because this was an example meant to just like use all of the adapters, we just cast it here as any, so the types don't complain. But the type system is actually the coolest part about the chat function, because if I remove as any here, it's going to complain. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to say OpenAI here. And the model now needs to be typed. So if I do something like GPT-5, I get all of this done. So all of these options are actually not related to the specific provider options. But if I want to define provider options, these are fully typed. And for example, if I want to pass text, so text is the way you pass in structured outputs, schemas to the LLM on OpenAI. And I say I want to do format, whatever. All of this is fully typed for you, but what I'm going to show you is the following. So let's say I've defined this text, and later on I want to change the model to something else. Let's say I want to use GPT-4 instead of 5. And I'm going to do GPT-4. Now, if I scroll over here, this is complaining. And the reason why it does that is because the type safety is on a per model basis. So if a model doesn't support structured outputs, the provider options are going to complain, and you're not going to be able to send this configuration to your LLM because it doesn't support that functionality. And all of this is done out of the box for you, so you don't really have to think about it. If the type is complaining, the model you're trying to use doesn't support that, and that's it. You don't have to worry about it, you don't have to check the docs, you don't have to go anywhere. It's all in your editor. And another cool thing about this is, if I open up messages, this is also true for messages. So for example, if I want to do content, because we support multimodal content. So for example, if GPT-5 doesn't support a video input, it's gonna complain. And for example, if I pass in text here, this is great and this works. And if I wanna pass in a type of image, I can do that as well. But if I wanna pass in something else, that's not gonna work. And for example, if you're using Gemini, Gemini supports a lot more inputs than OpenAI does. So if, for example, if I use Gemini 3 and I want to do a message, so I want to input something else, I can. So for example, you can input audio and video and stuff like that, and also documents into Gemini. So you could do that. And another cool thing is, for example, if I do source here, I can also define metadata, and the metadata is tied to the actual content part, and all the providers support different metadata. And if I do this, I can actually get the metadata for this provider. So for example, the MIME type for a document in Gemini is this. And for example, if I used OpenAI, if they had a different metadata, for example, they have detail on images, and if I switch back, I'm gonna use GPT-5. So this now complains, so I'm gonna delete it. And for example, I'm gonna open type image, and the metadata has the detail, and then it has auto, low, and high. And for example, so this is complaining because I'm missing source. And if I, again, switch to something else and that doesn't support the metadata or the source or whatever, the types complain. And that is how you get full type safety with the TanStack AI SDK. And this is really cool. So that's basically your backend. The chat returns a stream. And then you can return it as a response here with the abort controller. You just cast it with our helper utility that comes from the AI package, and then we return it to the client. So the client is the second part of the story, and the client consists of basically, so this is the React flavor, we also have Solid, of the useChat method. So the useChat method, you tell it where to connect to. So fetch server sent events, and it's going to connect to the API endpoint. So that's this. And you basically, this here allows you to connect to wherever you want. You can connect to your Python API, to Laravel, to PHP, to whatever you want. And then you define your tools. And when you define your tools, what's really cool is when you do messages, I'm just going to do messages zero parts, and I'm going to do zero here. So if I do type is equal to tool call, and I'm going to do if, and messages parts name is equal to, I actually get full type safety for every tool. So for example, if it's recommend guitar, I can open this up. I can do something like this, and the output is fully typed. So whatever the tool is, this is going to work. And why this is really cool is because you define your tools, as I showed you earlier, and then you pass it to both your client and your server, and then you get full type safety for tool definitions on both sides without having to define multiple tools that either execute or don't execute on the server and on the client. So this is your isomorphic tool approach, where we actually offer you a way to have this type safety very easily. All right, so now that we have that out of the way, let's talk about the useChat. So useChat actually returns messages. It returns the is loading. It returns the add tool approval response. That's the approval that you saw earlier. It returns the stop to basically stop the chat and to send messages. So basically, I think you already understand what all of this does. So send message actually sends it to your backend. Add tool approval response actually sends that to your backend as well, depending on if you say yes or no. And then you have your stop if you want to just abort the incoming message or whatever. The user clicks the stop button, it stops. And that is your hook. And then you have a bunch of your selects and components, and you have messages and the chat input area. So here, for example, you can see in the text area, you can on key down send a message. So you click enter, you send a message, or when you click the button, and then you also have your stop button here that's available when you're loading something, and then you have your messages. So the messages basically allow you to just render messages. I'm not going to go too deep into this part because the useChat hook is the important bit. The other things are just your implementations on the client on how you want to handle stuff. So for example, here, what we do is we say if the message role is an assistant one, we say AI, otherwise the user. And then you have your message parts. So for example, if the LLM is thinking, we're going to show this. If it's text, so basically a sentence, we're going to show this. If it's a tool call, we're going to handle it in this way. If it's another tool call, we're going to do this. And for example, so if it's a guitar recommendation, we render this component. We show the guitar that we got, and the user is happy. And that is your full deep dive into the current alpha of TanStack AI. I hope you have a great time playing with this, and let me know what you think. Do you like this? Do you think there are areas of improvement? Are you going to use it? Is it cool? Is it bad? I really want to know. And you are invaluable in helping us figure out the APIs before version 1. And if you have any ideas on how to improve this or would like to contribute, feel free to do so. And that is it for today. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one. Bye.